For 40 years, Ed and Lorraine Warren have committed their lives to the study and teaching of paranormal activity in its multitude of forms. Their research has inspired numerous national best-selling books and has spawned such Hollywood films as The Exorcist and Amityville Horror. Lorraine, a light transmedium, and Ed, an avid investigator of anything which hails from the netherworld, spend their lives trying to identify the unknown, patrolling the supernatural realm and investigating unexplained phenomena occurring worldwide. Over time, their contest with the dim side of this foreign sphere has posted them the keepers of its icons. It is here in a tightly secured museum attached to the offices of the New England Society for Psychic Research that Ed tends his collection of mystic items. Each comes with its own story and each its own intent. It is only through a diversity of religious blessings and cleansing ceremonies that their power is kept at bay. Ed's knowledge of paranormal science is vast, and his expertise vital to the cases in which he and Lorraine have been involved.
You have to be extremely careful in how you treat these things. Circularambulism, certain prayers, you don't go picking them up, you don't have your aura mingled with the aura of these things unless it's positively necessary, and even I don't. And there are many what we call death dolls here.
The doll you see here was made through black magic rituals. It's called a doll of shadows. Now, why is it called a doll of shadows? We'll take a look at it. It has human bones here and there and animal parts all over the body. You notice the nails in here and the tooth sticking out. Well, these are all feathers from crows and whatever. But this, I can tell through psychometry and through how it was made, that it was made with evil purposes. Now, the purpose is this, that they take a picture of this doll, they send it to you, and they put the curse on the back. You take it, and you look at it, and you laugh at it, but it's not a laughing matter. Because once you see the image of the doll, it can be projected telepathically to you in your dream state. Dolls like this have actually come into nightmares. These images of these dolls can be so frightening that they have actually stopped people's hearts during the dream state. A couple bought the doll from an antique dealer who practically gave it to them. They were doll collectors. And first night, both of them had scratch marks all over their body, and they had a horrible nightmare, the same nightmare, which is unnatural. The following night, it was not only scratch marks, it was claw marks, and very frightening. And they knew of us. They called me up. I went out there, and they said, take this doll, please. Take it. You see, you must be very careful with a doll like this. You can never destroy it. If you destroy it, you could have things occur to you that would be horrible. Because the spirits that are within the doll then are freed. And where do they go? To the one that destroyed their home. And this is their home right here.